We gather in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, a day after we celebrated the solemnity of the Sacred Heart of Jesus, we now celebrate the memorial of the Immaculate Heart of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Let us ask the intercession of this pure heart for each and every one of us, that we too may strive to perfection. To prepare ourselves for this Eucharistic celebration, let us acknowledge that we are all sinners in need of God's mercy. I confess to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who prepared a fit dwelling place for the Holy Spirit in the heart of the Blessed Virgin Mary, graciously grant that through her intercession we may be a worthy temple of your glory. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the second letter of Saint Paul to Timothy. Beloved, I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and by his appearing and his kingly power, proclaim the word. Be persistent, whether it is convenient or inconvenient. Convince, reprimand, encourage through all patience and teaching. For the time will come when people will not tolerate sound doctrine, but following their own desires and insatiable curiosity, will accumulate teachers and will stop listening to the truth and will be diverted to myths. But you, be self-possessed in all circumstances. Put up with hardship. Perform the work of an evangelist. Fulfill your ministry. For I am already being poured out like a libation, and the time of my departure is at hand. I have competed well. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, the crown of righteousness awaits me, which the Lord, the just judge, will award to me on that day, and not only to me, but to all who have longed for his appearance. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will sing of your salvation.
I will sing of your salvation.
My mouth shall be filled with your praise, with your glory, day by day. Cast me not off in my old age, as my strength fails, forsake me not.
I will sing of your salvation.
But I will always hope and praise you evermore and more. My mouth shall declare your justice, day by day, your salvation.
I will sing of your salvation.
I will treat of the mighty works of the Lord. O God, I will tell of your singular justice. O God, you have taught me from my youth. Until the present, I proclaim your wondrous deeds.
I will sing of your salvation.
So will I give you thanks with music on the lyre for your faithfulness, O my God. I will sing your praises with the harp, O Holy One of Israel.
I will sing of your salvation. Please stand.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Each year, Jesus' parents went to Jerusalem for the feast of Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up according to festival custom. After they had completed its days, as they were returning, the boy Jesus remained behind in Jerusalem, but his parents did not know it. Thinking that he was in the caravan, they journeyed for a day and looked for him among their relatives and acquaintances. But not finding him, they returned to Jerusalem to look for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were astounded at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished, and his mother said to him, "Son, why have you done this to us? Your father and I have been looking for you with great anxiety." And he said to them, "Why were you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be in my father's house?" But they did not understand what he said to them. He went down with them and came to Nazareth. And was obedient to them. And his mother kept all these things in her heart. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
We may think that the Holy Family, having Jesus with them, would be spared from stressful situations. Perhaps Mary thought that being the mother of God, being the mother of God who became man, her family, Joseph, Jesus, and herself, will be spared from trying times. But as the gospel reminds us, no, even the Holy Family underwent stressful situations. Kahit pala nasa iyo na si Jesus, hindi ka pa rin exempted sa mga pagsubok. Kahit pala kapiling mo na si Jesus, ay hindi ka pa rin spared sa mga tragic experiences. I think that should be very clear to us. Because sometimes, that is our question. Why? Nagpupunta naman ako sa simbahan, nagsisimba naman ako, sa katedral pa nga, no? Pagkalayo-layo sa amin, pero namamasahe ako para makapagsimba sa katedral. Bakit nangyayari ito sa amin? Why my favorite son? Why my husband? Why me? Those questions sometimes linger in our minds. Mabait naman ako, wala naman akong ginagawang masama sa aking kapwa. Eh bakit nangyayari pa rin ito sa akin? Sa amin, sa mga mahal ko sa buhay. Bakit ako? Bakit hindi yung walang hiyang kapitbahay ko? My dear brothers and sisters, today, again I say, we are being reminded that being with Jesus does not exempt us from stressful situations. Kaya, lagi nating tatandaan, kasama ng pagsunod natin kay Kristo ay ang pagpapasan ng krus. Walang exemption. You want to be a disciple of the Lord? You want to be close to the Lord? Then, carry your cross. That is the experience of the Holy Family. It is worrisome to lose a child in the crowd. Mary was worried. Joseph was worried. Why is it happening? And that is my second point. The questions. Why? Why? Your son, son, why have you done this to us? Hindi ba ganun din tayo? Lord, bakit? Bakit nangyayari ito sa akin? Bakit ito nangyayari sa pamilya ko? Why? But you know, at the end of the gospel, Saint Luke added this sentence, his mother kept all these things in her heart. Mary pondered the events, and perhaps her wise were replaced by what's the message. Siguro po ganun. Sa halip na tanong natin, Lord, bakit nangyayari ito sa akin? Baka mas magandang itanong eh, Lord, ano ang gusto mong sabihin sa akin sa pamamagitan ng mga pangyayaring ito? Sometimes, our whys should be replaced with our what is the message. Let us turn to the Immaculate Heart. Let us ask for her guidance and inspiration that when things do not happen the way we want them to be, we may be able to ask, what do you want me to understand. What do you want to tell me, Lord? Amen.
Please all stand.
Let us pray to God, our loving Father, that following the example of Mary, we may always seek and do His will. To every petition, our response would be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Church may practice the humility of Mary in willingness to serve God and man. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christ may find a welcome abode in the hearts of people as He found a well-prepared dwelling place in Mary. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The true spirit of prayer may deeply penetrate the hearts of people, that they may hear the cry of the poor as it permeated the whole being of Mary's Immaculate Heart. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are sick in mind and body may find healing and consolation through the powerful intercession of Mary. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dying may look up to Mary as their source of strength and comfort as she stood by the cross of her Son. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Lord and Master, cleanse our hearts that we may receive Christ, your only Son, in the spirit of Mary's faith and obedience. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Look, O Lord, upon the prayers and offerings of your faithful, presented in commemoration of Blessed Mary, the Mother of God, that they may be pleasing to you and may confer on us your help and forgiveness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on this memorial of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore, and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exultation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let us pray like Jesus. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Please all stand.
Let us pray. Having been made partakers of eternal redemption, we pray, O Lord, that we who commemorate the mother of your Son may glory in the fullness of your grace and experience its continued increase for our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May I invite you to please kneel, and together we will pray the prayer of consecration before the image of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. We have recourse to your protection, O Holy Mother of God, as we recite the words of this antiphon with which the Church of Christ has prayed for centuries. We find ourselves today before you, our Immaculate Mother, we who make up the body of Christ present in our land. Recite the words of this act of consecration and entrustment, in which we gather, first of all, the hopes and anxieties of our Filipino people at this moment of our history. Mother of our people, we rejoice in the name Pueblo Amante de Maria, a people who love Mary, bayang sumisinta kay Maria. You know all our sufferings and our hopes. You who have a mother's awareness of all the struggles between good and evil, between light and darkness, which afflict the world today. Mother of our people, accept the cry which we, deeply moved by the Holy Spirit, address directly to your heart. Embrace with the love of the mother and handmaid of the Lord our people and our land, which now we entrust and consecrate to you. For we are truly concerned for the earthly and eternal destiny of every individual among us and for all our people. We have recourse to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Despise not our petitions in our necessities. Dearest Mother, we consecrate and entrust to you our lives, our families, our nation, our archdiocese, to your loving and immaculate heart. From hatred, violence, and conflicts which divide and destroy our people, deliver us. From sins against human life, from its very beginning, deliver us. From the demeaning of the dignity of the children of God, deliver us. From every kind of injustice in the life of society, deliver us. From readiness to trample on the commandments of God, deliver us. From the loss of awareness of good and evil, deliver us. From sins against the Holy Spirit, deliver us. Accept, O Immaculate Mother of Christ, this cry. Laden with the hopes and burdens, the sufferings of each one of us and of all our people. Let there be revealed once more in our own history as a people the infinite power of the redemption, the power of merciful love. May it destroy the power of sin and evil among us. May it transform consciences. O Mary, Mother of Jesus and our Mother, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. Amen.
Please all stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.